Today we are out here with George Stacy at his apiary. And you've got how many beehives out here, George?
There's about 20 at this location.
Makes honey right here in Beaver Township. And we're getting ready to go back and check out all the hives. Now, what exactly do you put in the smoker that deters the bees?
I've been using dried hay. I found that it's easy to light and it does a pretty good job. People use just about anything, burlap, wood products, corn cobs.
Why does the smoke keep the bees at bay? Why is that?
The bees use pheromones or scents to communicate, and the smoke definitely covers up their communication system when you spray it in the front of the hive.
And does this just keep them away, or does it kind of calm them down a bit?
It kind of calms them down because they can't really communicate.
Ready to visit the hives, George told me to wear white. Bees are not colorblind, so light colors soothe the honeybees. Dark colors remind them of predators like bears or skunks. Also, make sure you keep your extremities covered and avoid heavy perfumes or lotions because scents can also aggravate honeybees. What made you go into the bee business, George?
Well, we just walked past a stump that had a beehive in it of wild bees. And my son didn't like having the bees there, so we ended up cutting down the tree and I took the bees out. And that started me with my first colony. So basically that is how I got started in it. My father had bees back during the Second World War. I remember the white boxes sitting out in the pasture field. And that sort of kept my interest all the years.
So how many bees per box?
Well, this time of the year, a box like this, we'd like to have 50 or 60,000 bees in it. Because they say that's a good number to produce honey.
So the elements of the beehive are, what is this called?
That's the telescoping cover.
Okay, and then this is?
This is the inner cover. And then what's below it is called supers. And they're different sizes. This is what we call a deep. It's about 9.5 inches high. And we use those for brood boxes. I like to keep my bees in two brood boxes. So this would be one and this would be the second one. And then I put on what we call a queen excluder, which is in here. This is a metal one. And then I have the honey supers on top. You have three different bees in here. We have the queen, one queen to each hive because they fight and kill each other. You have the male bees or the drones, which are absolutely useless if you have a good queen in here because the only thing that they do is eat honey and mate with a virgin queen.
That's the males?
Yes.
Good for nothing?
Yes.
There's the queen.
Right there's the queen. See her?
Oh, I see her. She's got the longer tail. Is that what that's called?
No, it's her body.
So it's only one queen per hive. And then are these all the female bees? They're doing all the work?
Yes.
And what did you call the male bees? The drones?
Drones, yes.
They just lay around and eat.
And the female bees are the worker bees.
Of course they are. So you can only extract honey once a year?
No, you can extract honey twice a year depending on
how productive the hives are?
Well, how productive the hives are and what the weather is like. Honey will ferment if it has too much moisture in it. So for it to definitely be honey, they have to evaporate it down to about 18% moisture.
So that brown liquid beneath the wax there is the honey.
Yeah, this is pretty close to being honey because they've started capping that over.
In the last few years, there's been such a decline. It seems like there's a bee shortage. What do you think is the cause of that?
I've pretty much come up with the chemicals that are being used. They've brought stuff in from other countries. That's where we've got the baromites, which weakens the bees. And then there's different pathogens that have been brought in from other parts of the world. And we have the chemical companies developing chemicals that kill the plants and kill the insects to the point where the bees don't have enough to eat, and it's just difficult to maintain them year after year.
George, if people wanted to buy your honey or learn more about beekeeping, what's the best way to contact you?
They could contact me by telephone. My number is 330-549-5472.
George, this has really been a really interesting day. I really appreciate you having us out. I mean, it's beautiful out here.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for sharing your farm and your hives with us.
Thank you.